First, we discuss sliding window protocols. In stop and wait protocol, we all know only one frame can be transmitted at a time. In stop and wait protocol, we all know only one frame can be transmitted at a time. So this results in serious inefficiencies when the bit length is increased. So to increase its efficiency, we must try to transmit more than one frame at a time. So to increase efficiency, we must try to transmit more than one frame at a time. So by using sliding window protocol, we are transmitting more than one frame at a time. Multiple frames need to be transmitted so that efficiency can be greatly increased. So in stop and wait protocol, only one frame can be transmitted at a time. In sliding window protocol, more than one frame can be transmitted at a time. So that is the difference between previous protocol, that is stop and wait protocol, and this sliding window protocol. So sliding window protocol, sender sends a fixed number of frames without getting the acknowledgement. Here each frame is labeled with one sequence number. Here sender sends a fixed number of frames without getting the acknowledgement from receiver. Here each frame is labeled with sequence number, and on getting acknowledgement from receiver, sender sends the more frames. Here each acknowledgement is labeled with respective frame sequence number. Here sender sends the multiple frames to the receiver before getting the acknowledgement for the first frame. Okay, so here sender sends the frame 1 and frame 2 before getting the acknowledgement for frame 1. That is the use of sliding window protocol. See, previous protocol, stop and wait protocol, here sender sends only one frame at a time. So in sliding window protocol, sender sends multiple frames at a time. So that is the difference between these two protocols, stop and wait protocol and sliding window protocol. Here this one is first one, 1-bit sliding window protocol. Here first one is 1-bit sliding window protocol. So here 1-bit sliding window protocol is used for delivery of data frames. Here 1-bit sliding window protocol is used for delivery of data frames. Here sender has sending window, here sending window, and receiver has receiving window. Here sender has sender windows 1, 2, 3, 4, and receiver has receiving window 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, here circles are windows. So sender has sending window and receiver has receiving window. Here the size of window size is 1. In 1-bit sliding window protocol, the size of window size is 1. Okay, sender window size is 1 and receiver window size is 1. In 1-bit sliding window protocol is 1 and receiver window size is 1. That means sender transmit one frame, okay, and receiver transmit one frame. Okay, that is 1-bit sliding window protocol. Here sender transmit a frame with sequence number and sender wait for acknowledgement from the receiver, and receiver send back an acknowledgement with that sequence number. Here sender transmit a frame with sequence number and then sender wait for acknowledgement from the receiver, and receiver send back an acknowledgement with that sequence number. See here, 0 to 7 are sequence numbers. Sequence number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here 0 to 7 are sequence number. Okay. Thus, if there are n bits, then the sequence number ranges from 0 to 2 power n minus 1. If there are n bits, the sequence number ranges from 0 to 2 power n minus 1. So here in this example, the number of bits are 3. So the sequence number ranges from 0 to 2 cube minus 1. That is 0 to 8 minus 1. So 0 to 7. So the sequence number ranges from 0 to 7. So here this one is 1-bit sliding window protocol. In 1-bit sliding window protocol, the size of sender window is 1 and the size of receiver window is 1. Here sequence number ranges from 0 to 7. So in this example, we take the bits, 3 bits. Okay. So 3 bits means here n value 3. So the sequence number ranges from 0 to 2 power n minus 1, 0 to 2 power 3 minus 1, that is 0 to 7. See here, A. Here, diagram A, that is the starting position, receiver waits for 0. Here, A, receiver waits for 0. So that's why here 0 is shaded. Okay. Here, A, receiver waits for 0. And next, B, here, sender sends 0. That's why here, at sending window, here 0 is highlighted. Okay. 0 is shaded. Okay. And next, C, receiver receives 0 and wait for 1. Here, receivers 0, receives 0 and wait for 1. So that's why 1 is shaded. Okay. So if receiver wait for particular frame, that is shaded. See here, at starting position, receiver waits for 0. So that's why 0 is shaded. And next B, here sender sends 0. So 0 is shaded. And next C, so here receiver receives 0 and wait for 1. So that's why here 1 is shaded. Okay. Suppose if the receiver wait for some sequence number, that sequence number is shaded. If sender sends some sequence number, that one is shaded. Last one, D. Here sender got acknowledgement from the 0. Sender got acknowledgement from the receiver, that is 0. For the frame 0. Okay. So 0 completed. So 0, frame 0 is transmitted and acknowledgement for the frame 0 is also received. So here D, here 0 is unshaded. That means the process of 0 is completed. Frame 0 is completed. So 0 is unshaded. And here D remains same. That means here D wait for 1. Okay, here receiver wait for frame 1. So this is 1-bit sliding window protocol. So at starting position A, receiver waits for 0. So 0 is shaded. Next B, sender sends 0. So 0 is shaded here sending window. Next C, receiver receives 0. So 0 is unshaded in the receiving window. That means here wait for 1. So 1 is shaded in the receiving window. And next D, sender got acknowledgement for 0. So 0 is unshaded and here receiving window 1 is shaded. That means receiver waits for 1. So if receiver waits for particular frame, that frame is shaded. Okay. So if sender sends particular frame, that frame is shaded. So after got the acknowledgement from the receiver, sending window, that frame is unshaded. So this is about 1-bit sliding window protocol. See here, there are two systems, A and B, okay? A sender and B receiver. Here, A sends 0. So here 0, that is sequence number, and here acknowledgement number and packet, okay? Or frame. Here sequence, acknowledgement number, frame, okay? So here star represents that packet for network layer has received. Packet for network layer has received. So here two scenarios, A and B. So here A, each frame brings a new packet for network layer and there are no duplicates. So here A, there are no duplicates. Here each frame brings a new packet for network layer. Here A0 frame brings a new packet for network layer. Here A0, okay. Here star represents this B gets the packet for network layer. And here B, second scenario. So this, in this scenario, there are duplicates. In this scenario, there are duplicates here. So let us discuss this one. So remember the point here, 0, first one, sequence number, and 1 here, acknowledgement number, and here A0 frame. See here. A sends 0, initially sequence number 0, and 1, A0, initially acknowledgement number 1. So A sends 0, 1 and A0 frame, and here B gets 0, 1, A0, and next B sends sequence number 0, and here 0 is acknowledgement for this 0. Acknowledgement for this 0. Okay, B sends acknowledgement for this 0. Yes, the frame 0 is received and sends B0. And next A gets 0, 0, B0. Next, second sequence number 1. A sends sequence number 1 and 0, okay, comma A1. And here B gets 1, 0, A1. And next, here A gets 1, 1, B1. Here B sends 1, 1, B1. And next A sends 0, 1, A2. So B gets this 0, 1, A2. And next B sends here 0. Okay. And next 0, here 0. Second 0 means acknowledgement for this 0. Here B gets 0. So acknowledgement for this 0, that is sent to A. And next, A sends another one, here sequence number 1, comma, initially 0, comma A3. And next B gets 1, 0, A3. And B sends next 1. And here acknowledgement for this 1, comma B3. So this is the first scenario. Here each frame brings a new packet for network layer. And next, here second scenario, here duplicates. Suppose here A sends 0, 1 and B sends 0, 1 and B gets 0, 1 here. A sends 0, 1, here B gets 0, 1. And next, here B unnecessarily resends 0, 0. Here B unnecessarily resends 0, 0. Why? Because here B already sends here 0, okay? So here B unnecessarily sends 0, 0. And next A gets 0, 1. That means here A gets 0 and no acknowledgement for the 0. See here. A sends 0. Here A waits for acknowledgement for this 0. So here, but A does not get any acknowledgement for that 0. Here A gets 0, 1. And next, here A unnecessarily sends, once again, 0, 0. Why? Because here A send already 0. Once again, here A sends 0. Okay. So this is unnecessary. Next here, A sends 0, 0, A0. So B gets 0, 0, A0. And next here, B sends 1, 0. And next, A gets 0, 0, B0. So here A already having 0. A already have 0. Okay. But here, this acknowledgement, that is here, this 0 is good acknowledgement. And next, A sends 1, 0, A1. And B gets this 1, 0, A1. And next, here B unnecessarily resends 1. Why? Because here B already sent this 1. Here B unnecessarily resends this 1. So this is about one bit sliding window protocol. Here A comma B, two scenarios. In the first scenario, each frame brings a new packet for network layer and there are no duplicates. See here, B0. Once again, this B0 is repeated. So here B0, B0, duplicate. Okay, in the scenario B, there are duplicates. And in the scenario A, there are no duplicates. Here A0, A sends A0, B gets A0. And B sends B0, B gets A gets B0. And next A1. So A0, B0, next A1, B1, next A2, B2, next A3, B3. So here in the scenario A, each frame brings a new packet for network layer and there are no duplicates. In the scenario B, here A sends A0. And once again, A sends here A0. So here there are duplicates in the scenario B. Okay. See here. In the scenario A, first A sends the data, then only B sends the data. And in the scenario B, A and B simultaneously send the data at a time. A and B both are sending data at a time. Okay. And in the scenario A sends the data, then only B sends the data. Here, A sends the data. After getting the data from A, then only B sends the data. But in the case of scenario B, A and B are simultaneously sends the data at a time. This is about one bit sliding window protocol. Next one, go back n sliding window protocol. Okay, next one is go back n. So here, go back n is a data link protocol that uses sliding window method. Here, next one, next protocol, go back n protocol. Here, go back n protocol is a data link layer protocol that uses sliding window method. So in this protocol, if any frame is corrupted or lost, all subsequent frames have to send again. Here in go back n protocol, if any frame is damaged or lost, then all subsequent frames have to be sent again. See here, frames 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, so here sender sends the frame 0 and sender sends the frame 1 and receiver sends the acknowledgement for the frame 0. Here acknowledgement 0 and receiver sends acknowledgement 1 for the frame 1. Okay, and next here frame 2 is error. Here frame 2 is damaged. Here 2e. So here frame 2 is damaged. Okay, then these all subsequent frames have to be sent again. Here all subsequent frames 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, all these subsequent frames have to be sent again here 3 4 5 6 7 8. Okay, this is go back n protocol. This one is go back n protocol. In go back n, if any frame is corrupted or lost, all subsequent frames have to be sent again. So if the receiver receives corrupted frame, it cancels it, and the receiver does not accept a corrupted frame. Here, here frame 2 is corrupted. Here receiver receives a corrupted frame, that is 2. Okay, and next all subsequent frames, that is 3 4 5 6 7 8, are discarded. Sender has to retransmit these frames 3 4 5 6 7 8. And next here sender sends also this frame, corrupted frame, once again. Here 2 is transmitted once again. Why? Because here 2 is corrupted, so here frame 2 is transmitted once again. And these all subsequent frames 3 4 5 6 7 8 are also sent to receiver once again. See here, go back n, that means if there is any corrupted frame or damaged frame, then go back to that frame, once again send the all the subsequent frames. That is go back n protocol. Next one, selective repeat. Next one is selective repeat. So it is a data link protocol that uses a sliding window method. It is a data link protocol that uses sliding window method. In this protocol, if the receiver receives a corrupt frame, it does not directly discard it. If the receiver receives a corrupt frame or damaged frame, it does not directly discard it, and it sends negative acknowledgement to the sender. And the sender sends that frame again as soon as receiving the negative acknowledgement. See here, selective repeat. If there is one damaged frame, then retransmit only that frame. Then retransmit only that frame. Okay, and remaining frames are buffered. There is no need to retransmit that remaining frames. See here, 0 and 0 is received, and 1 is transmitted, 1 is received, and 2 is transmitted, but here 2 is error. Here frame 2 is damaged. Okay, and here subsequent frames 3, 4, 5 are buffered. That means 3, 4, 5 are stored in a buffer. There is no need to retransmit these 3, 4, 5 frames. just retransmit that frame here too. Okay. And here receiver sends a negative acknowledgement here, NAK2. Here receiver sends NAK2, negative acknowledgement. That means there is an error in the one frame. Here, first one, acknowledgement 0, that is acknowledgement 0 for frame 0, ACK1, that is acknowledgement 1 for frame 1. And next here, it sends negative acknowledgement, NAK2. So here, negative acknowledgement means one frame is error here. Frame 2 is error. So that's why here, next time, the receiver sends a negative acknowledgement. So that error frame, that is frame 2, is retransmit again. And next frame, here 3 and 4, 5 are also transmitted. Here 3, 4, 5 are already transmitted. So there is no need to transmit these 3, 4, 5 frames once again. So next frame 6, okay. That is the difference between go back and select to repeat. In go back n, if there is one damaged frame, then retransmit that frame with all subsequent frames. See here, in go back n, there is a frame 2 with error. And consecutive frames, here subsequent frames 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 are discarded. Okay, we need to retransmit those frames 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 here. Error frame, that is 2 and 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But in select to repeat, if there is an error in one frame, we have to retransmit only that frame. And remaining frames are already in the buffer here. 3, 4, 5 are already in the buffer. Okay, there is no need to retransmit these frames 3, 4, 5. Simply transmit that error frame here 2. Okay. Next, here 3, 4, 5 are already transmitted. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and so on. 14. This is about select to repeat. Now we discuss operation of go back n protocol and select to repeat protocol. Operation of go back n protocol and select to repeat protocol. Here, sender sends a frame 0. See, in go back n protocol, the sender size is n and receiver window size is 1. In go back n protocol, sender window size is n, more than 1, that is n, and receiver window size is only 1. And in select to repeat protocol, sender window size is n and receiver window size is also n. Okay, if sender window size is 2 and receiver window size is 2, if sender window size is 3, receiver window size is 3. So in select to repeat, both sender and receiver window sizes are more than 1. In go back n, the sender window size is more than 1 and receiver window size is exactly 1. See here, go back n, here sender window size 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay, here 0, 1, 2, so window size is 3. And receiver window only here 1, here 0, 1, 2, 3, only 1. And in select to repeat, sender window size is here 0, 1 and receiver window size 0, 1. So window size is 2 and window size is 2. So in select to repeat, your sender window size 0, 1, so 2. Your receiver window size 0, 1, so 2. So sender window size is 2 and receiver window size is 2. So both window sizes are more than 1. Here, go back and normal operation. See here, sender sends frame 0. Your sender sends frame 0. Okay. See here, receiver waits for frame 0. Okay. And next, sender sends frame 1. Here, sender sends frame 1. So here, receiver wait for 1 and 0 is already received. So the sliding window moves to the 1. Okay. And next here, receiver sends ACK2. So acknowledgement for frame 0 and frame 1. Here, receiver sends acknowledgement for frame 0 and frame 1. So here, 0, 1 are received. So the window slides to 2, 3, 0. Okay, here 0, 1 are received by the receiver and got the acknowledgement from receiver. Here, sender got the acknowledgement from the receiver for 0 and 1. So the window moves to 230. Okay. Next here, sender sends frame 2. So here, receiver waits for frame 2. So here, receiver receives frame 0, 1. So here, the window moves to 2. Okay. And next, receiver sends acknowledgement 3. Here, receiver sends acknowledgement 3. That is acknowledgement for this frame, frame 2. So sender got acknowledgement for frame 2. So the window moves to here, 301. Okay, here 0, 1 and 2. Here sender got the acknowledgement for frame 0, frame 1 and frame 2. So that's why your window moves to the 301. So your sender sends frame 3. So your receiver wait for this frame 3. Okay. This is go back and normal operation. See here, go back and lost frame. See here, sender sends frame 0. So your receiver wait for 0. And frame 1, sender sends frame 1. So here, receiver wait for frame 1, this frame. And 0 is already received. So window moves to this one. And next, send the acknowledgement for this frame 0 and frame 1. Here, receiver sends the acknowledgement for this frame 0 and frame 1. So here, 0, 1, your sender got the acknowledgement from the receiver for 0 and 1. So here, sender slides the window to forward, move forward. And next here, frame 2 is lost. Here, sender sends the frame 2, but that frame 2 is lost. And next, sender sends the frame 3. See here, frame 3 is discarded. That means if any frame is lost in the go back N, the subsequent frames are discarded. Here, frame 2 is lost. So the next frame is discarded. Okay. Then resend that frame here. Sender resend that frame here, frame 2. Okay. And receiver sends the acknowledgement for this frame 2. Then resend once again frame 3. Okay. This is go back N. If there is any lost frame, then the subsequent frames are discarded. Once again, retransmit those frames. Okay. Here, frame 2 is lost. So we have to resend frame 2. And the next frame, that is frame 3, also resend. And select to repeat here. Sender sends the frame 0 and frame 1. And receiver sends the acknowledgement for these frame 0 and frame 1. And next here, sender sends the frame 2. But here, frame 2 is lost. And the next frame is not discarded. Here, the next frame 3 is not discarded. Okay. And here, receiver sends a negative acknowledgement. Here, receiver sends negative acknowledgement. That means one frame is received as error. So that's why your receiver sends negative acknowledgement. Then resend that frame. Okay. And next, your sender sends next frame 4. Your sender, no need to retransmit this frame 3 again. Here sender sends the frame 4. Okay. Frame 2, next frame 4. But in case of go back N, here sender has to retransmit this frame 3 again. Okay. But here in select to repeat, sender did not need to any retransmit this frame 3. Okay. Sender, no need to retransmit this frame 3 again. This is about sliding window protocol. So 1-bit sliding window protocol and sliding window protocol using go back N and sliding window protocol using select to repeat. So in sliding window protocol, sender has to transmit more than one frame at a time. So the previous protocol, stop and wait protocol, sender only transmit one frame at a time. In sliding window protocol, sender has to transmit more than one frame at a time. So your efficiency is greatly increased when you are using this sliding window protocol. There are three sliding window protocols: 1-bit sliding window protocol and go back N, third one, select to repeat. in sliding window protocol, one bit sliding window protocol, sender window size and receiver window size are one. In go back and sliding window protocol, here sender window size is more than one. Here in this example, sender window size is 3, 0, 1, 2, so 3, and receiver window size is only 1. Here 0, 1, 2, 3, only 1. And in select to repeat, the sender window size is more than 1. Here in this example, sender window size is 2, and receiver window size is also more than 1. That is here 0, 1, so 2. So this is about sliding window protocol.